What happens when you go beyond creating a simple flyer or a postcard into creating a multiple page document and you want to use page numbering? So what I want to do for this demo is create a new blank document. We'll come back to this offering memorandum in just a second. So what I'll do is hit Control N on my keyboard, and I want to specify the number of pages as 22. And after I've specified the number of pages, I'm going to go ahead for this demonstration and leave facing pages and click OK. So if I open up my pages panel, we'll see here that I have 20 pages and most of them are facing each other. And if we look really close, we can see that all of my pages have the letter A at the top, and that means that these are tied to the A master. And we're going to talk about master pages in the next following movies and chapters, but for this, we'll take a quick peek into what master pages do. So what I want to do is click on the A master. Now I want to assign a page number to this page. So the best way to do that is to grab the type tool. And as I come into the bottom left-hand corner of my page, I want to make sure that I draw a box long enough to fit the amount of pages that I'm going to have, and the typical rule of thumb is that you would make a box long enough to fit 999 pages. Now what's cool about this is I can just insert the character for page numbering, or I can add some text to it too, and I typically like to add like the word page with a colon space, and then once I've done that I can right click to bring up my contextual menu. I'm going to hover my mouse over Insert Special Character, and I want to choose Markers. And once I've reached Markers, I want to choose Current Page Number, and this is going to give me the current page number that I'm on. Now, why does this say an A? It says an A because I'm on the A master, and the A master isn't really considered a specific page, although the pages within our document are currently all connected to this A master. Now, if I want to apply any kind of style or formatting to this, I can simply do that. So here I'll increase the font size to, like, let's say 18, so we can really see it there on our page. Now, just to kind of show you the effect that this has, well, notice when I come into any page on my document, like page 2 here in the pages palette, we'll see that it says page 2. But if I pan over, we'll notice that there is no page marker on this page. Why? Because we didn't assign it on the A master second page. So I'm going to double click up there. And what I want to do is fit that spread in my window. And I want to grab my selection tool. And I want to hold down the Alt key as I select this. Holding down the Alt key and clicking and dragging will simply copy that object onto the next page. So this is currently bound to the right-hand side. Maybe I want this on the right-hand side of my box. So if I really wanted to, I could align this a little bit differently under the paragraph formatting options, but for this demo, I'll go ahead and leave it where it's at for now. But I'll come down and show you what that looks like. And we can see when we double click on page 2 and 3 InDesign, or 4 and 5, for an example, InDesign will, again, number these pages accordingly. Now, what if you want to do things like insert Roman numerals and that sort of thing? Well, then you get into wanting to learn about sections.